Welcome to this bridged introduction to helminthic therapy. First of all, what is a helminth? A helminth is an intestinal worm. A lot of people freak out when they hear the word worm, but the types of helminths used are perfectly safe, so small you can't even see them, and they're really no different than bacteria. Bacteria were demonized for decades, then we discovered that they're not all bad, and most of them are actually very good, even essential, and now you can supplement them in the form of probiotics. Helminths too. Since the beginning of time, there's been gravity. Humans evolved with gravity to the point where now we need it. If you take gravity away by going into space for an extended period of time, you start having health problems. The basis of helminthic therapy is exactly the same. We all used to carry symbiotic helminths, but now we live in industrialized societies where we wear shoes and have flushing toilets, we don't naturally have access to them anymore. But since we evolved with helminths, just like gravity, we need them now. A big part of how helminthic therapy works is by regulating bodily inflammation, which can play a role in both immune and genetic disorders. Without them, the chances of having illnesses like asthma, allergies, depression, anxiety, even the inflammatory subtypes of autism, multiple sclerosis, Crohn's, colitis, and so much more go way up. Of course, they're not healing you from these illnesses. They can just help moderate the symptoms and possibly even put them into remission. This evolutionary need for therapeutic helminths is called the biome depletion theory, and it applies to all organisms needed for a healthy gut microbiome, be they single-celled bacteria or more complex microorganisms. So in order to prevent these kinds of health problems and to treat them, we have to reintroduce our bodies to these vital symbiotic organisms, helminths included. Is helminthic therapy safe? Helminths have earned themselves a pretty bad reputation, but that's because whenever helminths are mentioned, they're either not talking about a species of helminth that would be safe to use therapeutically, or they're not being used in safe numbers. If you use therapeutic species in the proper doses, then yes, they are safe. Of all the species of worms in existence, the ones used in helminthic therapy have a very high standard to live up to. We don't use species that can be passed from one person to another. We don't use species that can reproduce within the human body, so you control exactly how many you have. They live in the gut and nowhere else in the body. They can't harm you, and they're pretty easy to get rid of. In fact, we often have to be careful not to kill them off by accident. What about the adjustment phase? Not everyone experiences side effects. But if you do, it'll typically be sometime within the first 3 months. That sounds like a long time, but it's usually not continuous and only at its worst at the midpoint, about 7 weeks in. And a lot of times there's what we call a bounce effect in the first few weeks, where you suddenly feel great. The intensity of both the good and the bad really depend on your own immune system. But if you want to keep the discomfort to a minimum, you can always start with a smaller dose. And there are also tricks to minimize side effects once they appear. How long until you see results? Some people have seen miraculous improvements as early as just a few weeks in, and others have had to wait up to nearly 2 years. It really depends. Helminths aren't like a drug or as simple as a single-celled bacterial probiotic. They're complex organisms that develop their immune modulating capabilities over an extended period of time. If your body's not used to having helminths, it'll need time to adjust. A lot of people are tempted to rush to work up to a higher number, believing that more helminths will lead to faster results. But a lot of times it really comes down to how much time you've given them to work, more than how many you have. A dysfunctional immune system can't be fixed overnight, but through the presence of therapeutic helminths, can learn how to function more intelligently. It rarely comes down to having a higher number of helminths. In future installments, I'm planning to cover choosing what species would be best for you, dosing recommendations, how to order a shipment, what exactly to expect during the adjustment phase, how to reduce unpleasant side effects, and more. These videos are intended to be a simplified overview of helminthic therapy, but the best source of in-depth information is the helminthic therapy wiki on which these videos are based. If you're interested in beginning therapy, I highly recommend consulting the wiki first to make sure you have a full and detailed picture and can make the most informed decision possible. Once you've read up, you'll be ready to take the plunge. And if you have any questions, the Helminthic Therapy Support Facebook group would be happy to help. The information in this video can be found on the wiki page, Introduction to Helminthic Therapy, and I will see you guys in the next installment.